Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics and machines. And this is lecture number 7.2. We are discussing the boundary layer theory. So in the earlier lecture, we studied about the boundary layer formation, boundary layer thickness, displacement thickness, momentum thickness, and energy thickness. And in this lecture, we continue with the boundary layer theory. We will derive the boundary layer equation, von Karman equation, laminar boundary layer, turbulent boundary layer, and we will discuss about the boundary layer separation. The learning outcome to the students. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to derive the von Karman momentum integral equation and explain the boundary layer separation. The boundary layer equation. The boundary layer equation for steady flow over a flat plate for incompressible inviscid fluid in two dimensions without body forces. We have to write down the equations. First, the continuity equation for two dimensional flow, dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y equal to 0. And the momentum equation for two dimensional flow, neglecting the body forces. The body force, they are the force due to the acceleration due to gravity. So the equation, x momentum equation, u dou u by dou x plus v dou u by dou y equal to minus 1 by rho dou p by dou x. And the y momentum equation, u dou v by dou x plus v dou v by dou y equal to minus 1 by rho dou p by dou y. And the equation 10, 11, 12, they are for inviscid fluid flow within the boundary layer. So, inviscid means non-viscous. So, the ideal fluid flow. The boundary layer flow, the viscous effect of the fluid is to be included in the above equations. In the above equations, the viscous force term is not considered. Now, there is no change in the continuity equation. And equation number 11, x momentum equation, we are adding the effect of viscosity. So, u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y equal to minus 1 by rho dou p by dou x. And this term, nu into dou square u by dou y square, it is included. So, this gives the effect of the viscosity of the fluid. And equation number 12 is unchanged because of the shear stress in the x directions only. However, the equation is simplified by neglecting the terms of lower magnitude. So, the final equation number 12 is simplified as minus 1 by rho dou p by dou y equal to 0. Now, the complete equation for two-dimensional non-viscous fluid flow, incompressible viscous fluid flow in two-dimensional without body forces. So, the first equation is continuity equation 13, equation number 13. Equation number 14 is the momentum equation in the x direction, and equation number 15 is the momentum equation in the y direction. Now, the equation 13, 14, 15 are known as Prandtl's boundary layer equation for two-dimensional steady flow of incompressible fluid. So, Prandtl's boundary layer equation. Using these equations, we are going to derive the von Karman equation. So, for the equation, we require boundary conditions for flow over flat plate. The free stream velocity is capital U. And here, the boundary layer thickness is delta. And the velocity is increasing in the y direction. So, on the surface of the plate, y equal to 0, the velocity equal to 0, U equal to 0. And the velocity is increasing in the y direction. And it is equal to capital U, 0.99 times of capital U on the boundary layer. So, at y equal to delta, so U, small u equal to capital U. And at y equal to delta, the velocity is constant equal to capital U and du by dy equal to 0. So, these are all the three boundary conditions. We have three equations and three boundary conditions. Now, we have to solve the equations. So, we are going to derive the momentum integral equation using the above conditions. We consider the boundary layer. We take a small fluid element of ABCD at a distance x from the leading edge and the thickness of delta x. Now this ABCD is enlarged here. Now delta x is the thickness of the fluid element, dy is the, you take a small strip here of thickness dy from the base at a distance y from the x equal to 0, that is y equal to 0. So from here, from the horizontal plate, at the height of y, we take a small elemental fluid strip of dy. Now we take the thickness of the fluid strip is dy. Now the fluid, so this is the small element of fluid. So the fluid is entering here at AD, and the fluid is entering here at DC, and it is fluid is leaving here at BC. So fluid enters through AD, fluid enters through the DC, and fluid leaves through the BC. Now u is the velocity at any point within the boundary layer, and b is the width of the plate. So width of the plate, so this is the length of the fluid element or length of the plate delta x, and this is the height of the boundary layer delta, actually this is the height, and b is the width of the plate. So width of the plate is perpendicular to the screen, which is considered as, so we take b is the width, finally we simplify while we solve the problem, we will simplify for the given condition. So b is the width of the plate right now. The mass flow rate of the fluid entering through the side AD. So mass flow rate from the continuity equation. So mass flow rate equal to integral 0 to delta. So within the boundary layer, integral 0 to delta rho into velocity into area of the strip of thickness dy. So rho is the density. Velocity here at this point is u. And area is area of the strip equal to dy is the thickness and b is the width perpendicular to the screen. So b into dy is the area, u, rho is the density, u is the velocity, that is the mass flow rate through the side AD. Now mass flow rate of the fluid leaving through the side BC on the other side, opposite side. Now mass flow rate through the AD plus dou by dou x, you can consider this diagram. So the mass flow rate leaving on the other side, so dou by dou x of mass flow rate through AD into dx. So the first term we derived earlier, so 0 to integral 0 to delta rho u b into dy. Now dou by dou x of the entire term rho u integral 0 to delta rho u b dy into delta x. That is the quantity of mass flow rate of the fluid leaving through BC. Now the mass, we said mass is entering, the fluid is entering through AD, fluid is entering through DC, and fluid is leaving through BC. Now from the continuity equation for the steady incompressible flow, we may write as mass of the fluid entering through AD plus mass of the fluid entering through DC, that is equal to mass of the fluid leaving through BC. Now we have to calculate mass of the fluid entering DC. So mass of the fluid entering BC equal to mass of the fluid leaving BC minus mass of the fluid entering AD. So these two terms we have, right hand side two terms we have, we substitute. So mass of the fluid entering DC equal to mass of the fluid leaving BC minus mass of the fluid entering AD. So substituting integral 0 to delta rho u b into dy plus dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta rho u b dy into delta x minus 0 to delta integral 0 to delta rho u b dy. Now these two terms, first term and the third term, they are getting neglected. So they are same terms with the negative sign, opposite sign. So they are getting cancelled. So finally we will get dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta rho u b into dy into delta x. So this is the mass of the fluid entering through DC. So the fluid entering through the side DC with a uniform velocity u. Now we calculate the momentum flux through the control volume. So momentum flux through the AD. So momentum flux equal to mass of the strip into velocity. So mass of the strip into velocity equal to mass, already we have calculated, integral rho u b into dy into velocity, that becomes 0 to integral 0 to delta rho u square b into dy. So mass, remember, mass equal to rho u b into dy. Now multiplying with velocity u, so the momentum equal to mass into velocity, so rho u square b into dy. then momentum flux leaving the side BC. So the same thing multiplying by another u. So rho u square b into dy plus dou by dou x integral 0 to delta rho u square b into dy delta x. Then the momentum flux leaving the side DC, entering the side DC, that is equal to dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta rho u b dy delta x into capital U. Because from this strip, from the strip actually, the strip, the fluid is entering with the velocity U, capital U. So that is why we are multiplying here by capital U. So here we are multiplying by capital U because the fluid is entering from the outside the boundary layer, the fluid is entering with the velocity capital U. So this becomes dou by dou x integral 0 to delta rho u capital U b into dy into delta x. Now this is the equation. So from here the fluid is entering with capital U. The rate of change of momentum of the control volume for incompressible fluid, that is equal to momentum flux through BC minus momentum flux through AD minus momentum flux through DC. So substituting all the values, momentum flux through BC, rho u square b into dy plus dou by dou x of zero integral 0 to delta rho u square b into dy delta x minus AD minus integral 0 to delta rho u square b dy minus dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta rho small u capital U b into dy into delta x. Now these two terms, first term and the third term, are getting cancelled. So finally dou by dou x of, we can combine these two terms, second term and the fourth term we can combine. So dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta rho u square b into dy minus integral 0 to delta rho u capital U small u capital U b into dy delta x. So the second term here and fourth term here. Now the rate of change of momentum of the control volume for incompressible fluid, we can combine the two terms, dou by dou x of rho b into integral, rho b they are constant taken out of the integral 0 to delta u square minus small u capital U dy into delta x. Or you can write rho b into dou by dou x of, so rho b is constant, it is taken out of the differentiation, rho b into dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta u square minus small u capital U dy into delta x. So we call this is the equation number 16. So this is the rate of change of momentum for the control volume, small control volume ABCD. So you remember this equation, this is required for further discussion. According to the momentum principle, the rate of change of momentum of the on the control volume ABCD must be equal to the total force on the control volume in the same direction. So this is from the momentum principle or Newton's second law of motion. Rate of change of momentum on the control volume ABCD must be equal to the total force on the control volume in the same direction. So we have to consider, we have to calculate the total force of the for the flat plate. There is no external pressure force on the control volume. So dou P by dou X equal to 0. As the velocity is constant, the force on the side DC is negligible and the velocity gradient is negligible. So the only external force on the control volume is the shear force acting on the side AB in the direction B to A. So the shear force acting here, tau O is the only force acting here, but it is in the opposite direction of the fluid flow. So this is minus tau O. So shear, tau E stands for, tau stands for shear stress and O stands for the surface of the plate. So tau O into area. Delta X is the length and B is the width of the plate. So, actual thickness or width of the plate perpendicular to the screen. So, delta X into B. Now, the negatives then indicate that the shear stress is acting in the opposite direction to the rate of change of momentum. So, now we have to equate these two. The rate of change of momentum is equal to net force. The net force equal to minus tau into delta X into B. The rate of change of momentum equal to rho B dou by dou X of 0 to integral 0 to delta u square minus small u capital U dy into delta x. Now delta x b, that is getting cancelled. So the delta x is cancelled, b is cancelled. So what is left out in the left hand side? Minus tau o equal to rho into dou by dou x integral 0 to delta u square minus u into dy. Now tau o equal to, I take the negative sign to the other side, minus rho into dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta u square minus u du dy. Or we remove the negative sign by changing the direction, rho into dou by dou x of 0 to integral 0 to delta small u capital U minus u square dy. So this is the equation. Further we simplify. So the tau o equal to rho u square, I take u square multiply by, I take u square outside. So rho u square dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta u by capital U into 1 minus small u by capital U dy. So to verify, you can multiply the equation by u square, you will get the same equation as in the previous page. Now we take the rho u square to the left side. So tau o by rho u square equal to dou by dou x of integral 0 to delta small u by capital U into 1 minus small u by capital U dy. Now, we defined the momentum thickness earlier in the previous lecture. Momentum thickness theta equal to integral 0 to delta U by capital U into 1 minus U by capital U dy. Now, you compare these two equations. Right hand side, within the square bracket, the value is theta. So, substituting in the previous equation, tau by rho u square equal to dou theta by dou x. This is the momentum, von Karman momentum integral equation for boundary layer flow. Now, what is required? We require the velocity profile. So, once you know the velocity profile, we can substitute here u by u. U by u is the velocity profile. You substitute here, we can calculate the momentum thickness. Then the momentum thickness can be substituted in this equation, and by doing the integration, we'll calculate what is the theta value, what is the velocity value we can calculate. That is what called as momentum, von Karman momentum integral equation. For the given velocity profile in the laminar zone, Francis zone or turbulent zone of the boundary layer, the shear stress may be obtained using the equation 18. So, we can calculate the tau o value, shear stress value for any type of flow, laminar flow, transition flow or the turbulent flow. Now, once you know the shear stress, then you can calculate the drag force. So, the main purpose of calculating shear stress is you have to calculate the drag force. The drag force is the force resisting the fluid flow in the boundary layer. On the surface, when the fluid is in contact with the solid surface, the force is drag force. Determining the drag force is very important in the fluid mechanics. So, the drag force delta Fd equal to shear stress into area. So, shear stress we calculate from the von Karman equation, and delta x into B is the thickness of the fluid element and B is the width of the fluid element. Now, to calculate the total drag force on the plate for the entire length L equal to L, we have to integrate this equation. So, total drag force Fd equal to integral of delta Fd, which is integral of 0 to L, shear stress tau o B into dx. So, the shear stress equation, the value of shear stress, we have to calculate from the previous equation, von Karman equation. Then, you have to substitute here, integrate again between 0 to L length of the plate. Then, we can calculate the total drag force on the plate. Then drag coefficient. So, drag coefficient is defined as the ratio of shear stress to the quantity rho u square by 2. So, CD star, local drag coefficient, that is equal to tau o divided by 1 by 2 rho u square, and the average drag coefficient or the drag coefficient CD equal to FD, drag force divided by 1 by 2 rho a u square. So, these equations you have to remember. Sometimes they may ask you calculate the average drag coefficient. So, drag force you have to calculate first, then you have to calculate the drag coefficient. And where A is the area of the plate, rho is the density of the fluid, and U is the free steam velocity. So, to calculate the drag force, first you have to use the calculate the momentum thickness, then you have to substitute in the von Karman momentum integral equation. You have to calculate the shear stress, then you have to calculate the drag force, then you have to calculate the drag coefficient. So, all these calculations you have to do step by step to calculate the drag coefficient and drag force on the flow over the plate. But this is analytical solution. Theoretically, using the mathematical derivation, we are doing all these calculation. But experimentally, Blasius is the scientist who obtained the exact analytical solution for laminar bound layer, and the solutions are given below. The bound layer thickness delta by x equal to 5 divided by square root of Reynolds number at x. X is the local bound layer thickness and for any given value of x. And local drag coefficient equal to CD star equal to 0.664 divided by square root of Reynolds number at x. And average drag coefficient for the entire length of the plate, CD equal to 1.328 divided by square root of Reynolds number at L. L is the length, for entire length, total length of the plate, we have to calculate the Reynolds number. And displacement thickness, delta star divided by x equal to 1.729 divided by square root of Reynolds number at x. Momentum thickness, theta by x equal to 0.664 divided by Reynolds number at x. Then the drag force equal to integral 0 to L shear stress B into dx, tau O B into dx, integrating, substituting tau O and integrating the value will get 0.664 rho B u to the power 0.333 nu kinematic viscosity to the power 0.5 and L to the power 0.5. L is the length, nu is the kinematic viscosity, u is the free steam velocity. So we can calculate the drag force. And these results are obtained by Blasius, and there is no derivation, it is analytical solution. For exact solution, experimentally he determined all the values. Then for similarly for turbulent bound layer, so for laminar bound layer, the previous slide details are given. For turbulent bound layer, we have to calculate all the results again. The turbulent bound layer are thicker than the laminar bound layer. Because of the random movement of the fluid particle in turbulent bound layer, the velocity distribution is much more uniform than that in the laminar bound layer. So, based on the experiment, Blasius gave the following velocity profile for turbulent bound layer. So, velocity profile equal to small u by capital U equal to y by delta to the power n, where n equal to 1 by 7, when the Reynolds number is less than 10 power 7 and greater than 5 into 10 power 5. So, u by u equal to y by delta to the power 1 by 7. And using the solution as in the previous case, he calculated the bound layer thickness delta by x equal to 0.376 divided by Reynolds number to the power 1 by 5, that is 0.2. And the local drag coefficient CD star equal to 0.059 divided by Reynolds number to the power 1 by 5, Reynolds number at x to the power 1 by 5. And the average drag coefficient CD equal to 0.074. Reynolds number L to the power 0.2. For Reynolds number less than, greater than 5 into 10 power 5 and less than 10 power 7. And the CD value equal to 0.455 into log 10 Reynolds number to the power 2.58 for Reynolds number less than 10 power 9 and greater than 10 power 7. And average drag coefficient for laminar turbulent combined condition. So you can use this equation, CD equal to 0.074 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.2 minus A by Reynolds number to the power L, when the Reynolds number range equal to greater than 5 into 10 power 5 and less than 10 power 7. And the CD value again equal to 0.455 divided by logarithmic of base 10 Reynolds number to the power 2.58 minus A by Reynolds number for Reynolds number value in the range of less than 10 power 9 and greater than 10 power 7, where the A value is taken from the table. So for different values of Reynolds number, you can take the constant A. So, for turbulent, these equations, you need not worry about all these equations in the examination. If they ask a problem, they will give the equation. It is very difficult for anybody to remember this equation exactly. So, the equations will be given, you have to calculate. So, for the, we have to calculate, remember, for the boundary, using the bound layer theory, for flow over a flat plate, we have to calculate the local drag coefficient, average drag coefficient and drag force on the plate. So, drag force is the force which is opposing, which is resisting the fluid flow. So, the objective of the bound layer theory is to calculate the drag force for the flow over the flat plate. To calculate the drag force, you have to use the momentum, the von Karman momentum integral equation to calculate the shear stress. Then, we have to calculate the drag force. Using the theoretical calculation,
or you can use the equations proposed by Blasius, and you can calculate the various parameters given in the using the equations. Then the boundary layer separation, the concept of boundary layer separation. When a solid body is immersed in the flowing fluid, a thin layer of fluid formed adjacent to the solid surface called boundary layer. We know boundary layer. So the when the fluid is flowing over a solid surface, there will be a small layer, right? So within the layer, we have to consider the effect of viscosity. Outside the layer, outside the boundary layer, the effect of viscosity is negligible. The forces acting on the fluid within the boundary layer are inertia force, viscous force, and the pressure force. The three forces are acting. Outside the boundary layer, the viscous force, effect of viscous force is neglected. Now, when the fluid pressure decreases in the direction of the flow, so obviously the pressure is decreasing because of the resistance, because of the viscous resistance. The pressure gradient is negative, dP by dx is less than 0, then the flow is accelerated. When the pressure gradient decreasing, the velocity of the fluid is increasing. So in this case, the pressure force and the inertia force together reduces the effect of the viscous force in the boundary layer. So the thickness of the boundary layer is low and the boundary layer is attached to the solid surface. So because the pressure force is decreasing, dP by dx is less than 0, the pressure force and inertia force together reduces the effect of viscous force in the boundary layer. So the thickness of the boundary layer is smaller and it is attached to the surface. So look at this diagram. So this is the solid boundary on which the fluid is flowing. And there is a generation of the boundary layer, right? And within the boundary layer, the velocity profiles are shown here. So this is the velocity profile at this location B, and here it is the velocity profile, and at S this is the velocity profile, and at D this is the velocity profile. Now at the point B, this dP by dx is less than 0. At the point C, the P minimum, so the dP, actually P is pressure is minimum and dP by dx is 0. And here on the outside at the point S, dP by dx is greater than 0. So, when the dP by dx is greater than 0, the flow is in the opposite direction. So, the separating starts. The flow separation starts. What is flow separation? The fluid layer is away from the surface. It is not, there is no physical contact between the fluid particle and the surface. That is what called as separation. When the fluid pressure increases in the direction of the flow, the pressure gradient is positive, that is dP by dx is greater than 0, and the pressure force acts the opposite to the direction of the flow. The pressure force is acting in the opposite direction. This increases the retarding effect of the viscous force, and the thickness of the boundary layer increases rapidly. At this particular point, the boundary layer is separated from the surface and moves into the mainstream. So this phenomena is called as boundary layer separation. So this you have to understand. So here the dP, when the dP by dx is greater than 0, the boundary layer thickness is rapidly decreasing, and the fluid particle, because of the pressure force, higher pressure force, the pressure is acting in the opposite direction. So the boundary layer thickness grows and the fluid particle starts to getting separated. So that is what the boundary layer separation. The point of the body at which boundary layer is on the verge of separation from the surface is called as point of separation. So in this diagram, S is the point of separation. The boundary layer separation is undesirable phenomena and it should be controlled. So the boundary, it is not desirable. Particularly in fluid mechanics, the boundary layer separation is not desirable. So when the fluid is separated from the surface, there is no contact between the surface and the fluid. So the effective energy transfer is getting affected. So we have to control and we have to retain the contact between the fluid and the solid surface. So that is what we have to control, the boundary layer separation. So what are the methods used for controlling the boundary layer separation? The first method is motion of solid boundary. Suppose there is a fluid flow through over a cylinder, so we can rotate the cylinder. So in the direction of the fluid flow, we can rotate the cylinder so that we can maintain the contact of the fluid particle on the surface. Then the another method, acceleration of the fluid particle within the boundary layer. So we can have the in the solid surface we can have small cavity, and in the cavity we can have some fluid, and the fluid will be supplied here so that we can maintain negative pressure gradient. So we can supply the fluid from here, or you can have an opening like this. So the from the pressure side we can supply the fluid here so that we can maintain the physical contact between the fluid on the surface, and we can maintain negative pressure gradient. Or there is another method called suction method, suction of fluid from the boundary layer. So we can have the cavity on the downstream side of the aerofoil, so we can absorb, we can consume some amount of, we can accommodate some quantity of air here or fluid here, so that the pressure, negative pressure gradient can be maintained. So using any one of the method, we can maintain the boundary layer, we can maintain the fluid in contact with the surface so that we can avoid the boundary layer separation. So in the fluid mechanics, in the design of any fluid machines, it is very important that we have to see that the boundary layer is not separated from the surface of the solid surface. So in addition to the above method, streamlining of the body shape and guiding the flow in a confined space are also used to control the boundary layer separation. So first you have to understand the boundary layer separation, and we have to think about the pressure gradient dp by dx, and we have to maintain dp by dx negative so that the boundary layer will be sticking onto the surface. The fluid will be sticking onto the surface. There will be contact between the fluid and the solid surface. When the pressure gradient is positive, dp by dx is greater than 0, then there is a separation of the fluid particle, which is to be controlled by any one of the method given in the text. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published earlier in mechanical engineering, and you may find one book, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery, which can be referred for further information of the boundary layer theory. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subjects, and the answers to the question, the discussion on the gate question paper is also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You can subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning, and pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. So you subscribe the channel, and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. And we'll meet again in another video in the subject, fluid mechanics and machines.